The long-suffering family of one of the Snowtown victims has broken their silence amid the imminent release of callous monster Mark Haydon.
They're terrified he could end up living and working among them, and despite calls to keep him locked up, legal experts say he will walk free.
Ronald Lane was 11 when his uncle Barry disappeared.
He got murdered. He was covered in acid, in some of these blue barrels.
That was 1997. 2 years later, his body was found in a Snowtown bank vault. The gruesome killing of the 42-year-old who called himself Vanessa featured in a chilling movie. But his nephew says the family's now living a real-life horror with the imminent release of Mark Haydon.
I saw the word Snowtown. The story was about him getting released in May. And we're trying to stop that because we fear that he might hurt some more other victims.
Of course they're worried. I totally understand that. But he will be released in May.
Haydon helped conceal the bodies of 7 victims, including his own wife, murdered by John Bunting, Robert Wagner and James Lasakis. His 25-year sentence ends in May, and despite the state government exploring options to prevent his release, Ms Nelson says no law can keep him locked up.
I don't know on what basis he could be. There's nothing in our current legislation that would permit that.
She oversaw the rejection of Haydon's last bid for release in 2017.
He had been in prison for a very long time, and we felt he needed a period of reintegration and resocialisation.
So, for the past 7 years, Haydon, now in his 60s, has been accessing social workers, vocational courses, and even had the option to join the CFS. When released, he wants to volunteer.
He'd been a very easy prisoner to manage. He's demonstrated quite clearly that he understands the impact he's had.
There are now concerns about where Mark Haydon would live. With next to no available public housing, there's a very real possibility he could end up in a shared boarding house. And many say that scenario would be less than ideal.
Often rife with drugs, alcohol and violence, authorities fear it could put Haydon back on a bad path.
He may say things to the right people, saying that he's probably sorry, you've done what you've done, and that's it.
Elspeth Hussey, 7 News.